school.
Just call out a wee bit here, guys. It's very, very heavy. Let's see, it's trying to slow up in places. But don't go too mad trying to fill it out the first day. Get most important thing is get scud coated, scratch coated. That'll take off for a whole day, and then you may be able to get another wee quick tight coat on, and then another coat on, and straighten it out. Rub it. But just trying to make this corner out because I know it's very heavy. Don't get it out now. Ain't that ever get it out. Get your first coat on. Make sure you fill out the heaviest parts and don't get too greedy. Don't try and get it all done in one go. And you're working over stone. Not nice fresh flat and a nice flat straight. So you wanna bring it out stages gradually. So you're just then scraps. So we'll come back guys and show you the day getting straightened up the room. I'll put on, strip it up the room and get it all devil fluid ready for the skin coat. And you can see up the top I have this stage I put the boards on. So that's up north too. And the likes of this side here. I need to strip some of that off, but this paper will be coming off to do my skin coat into the original skin here. So I'll not probably take that off until I'm gonna. Yeah, I'll take it off after the next coat cook or just before it goes on so I don't have to keep on washing that side as well. But I'll come back guys and show you it all in the shape here.
Right, so guys, that's my slack there, the smooth bits. I have the paper stripped off and you just pull your rule up, your straight edge up off the original plaster. And that'll bring it back to the original shape that it was at. You can sort of see when you are rendering, the smooth bits that are left at the stage are the parts that you have to fill in again. So you can just about make it out there. The rough areas are actually out nice and flush, so they don't need any more on them. And that's the smooth areas there, marking them out so I know where to fill. It's quite a handy wee tactic to do when you're working, and you can wait when you're just starting doing rendering. It gives you a good idea of where to fill up close and get it filled in from there. So also pull your rule across the wall to get it well straightened. So guys, I've went ahead here and dabble fluted it, give myself a good key for the skim coat. On the side here, I've cut it back to the original. It's cut back about 3 mil. That should be plenty to allow a good skim coat and bring it in nice and flush back to the original. So guys, if you want to see me rubbing up dabble floating walls, you'll find some harder renders videos on the channel as well. So guys, I've just finished the second coat on the wall here, and actually went on very neat. Took time putting on the second coat, almost trailing it in as I was coating it. As I say in other videos, and I'll say in many more to come, that the tidier and neater you are from the word go, the easier the job will be. So you can see here, get the camera right, and you'll see that there's literally no gap. I know it's still soft at the minute, but there's no gap here, and the wall will trail up very flush, and whatever way they want to decorate it, then it'll come in. And there's the ceiling spawned and skimmed. So guys, I'll not bore you too much, and there will be more tutorials coming up, and I'll get this cleaned up for now.